Yo, dope people, keep it real, Tarmac. Shout out. Love. Peace.
All graffiti artists hold tight. All graffiti artists hold tight.
I think my first experience with graffiti was when I was like about 3 or 4 years old, man. When I would see people just tagging on the walls in my neighborhood, you know? I was a little kid, man. I just see people writing all over the place. You know, so it's for me, it's been around since I was born, you know?
Bio and Brim come again with BG-183. Recognize me with the mad colors. I'm a fiend for spray paint.
Graffiti art has come a long way. You know, yeah, it's evolved. It went from the trains to the walls. Once it came to the walls, you know, it started developing that whole street art movement. So, you know, it's taken its natural progression, man, you know, and grown. You know, but the one thing you gotta remember, man, graffiti's graffiti, street art is street art. It's a totally separate thing. In graffiti, we concentrate on the name, on the person, on the crew, as to where street art is all about, you know, more aesthetic art, more stuff for more people. Graffiti's still underground, it's still hardcore, still raw. It's like that in-your-face type of shit, you know? It's just realness, man. You know, pure expressionism, man. You don't have to be a talented artist. You could just have to rock your letters, rock your name, you know? And you could do it everywhere, on any surface, man. Moving, stationary, whatever. Oh, absolutely, man, absolutely. I do it all the time, man. You know, I put my graffiti on canvases and whatnot. We have exhibitions, we do jams, you know, and we take it all over the world, man. You know, like back in the days, from Fashion Moda to the Sydney Janus Gallery, where they brought it out to Europe, you know, in shows. You know, guys like Lee, who pioneered bringing graffiti art into the main street, into the mainstream, you know. It's been done. It's been done. It's happening, and more is coming. Yeah, that's the easy way to go, man. You know, it's more technical and whatnot. You know, that's the generation that we live in. I call it the microwave society, man. Everything has to be done fast. Bing, done, you know? You know, you got to look at graffiti art, man, as looking at Da Vinci, as Michelangelo. You know, they studied the letters, they studied the things, you know, and they created it by hand. You know, they took on protégés, they taught them. You know, nowadays, you know, you go to a school, graffiti, you don't learn it in a school. You learn it in the streets. You know, in school, you learn how to use the iPad, the Mac, and all these programs, you know, to cheat. And it comes out good and it's beautiful and everything, but it's not real. It's virtual. Well, it's about, you know, who could bring style, all the elements, you know, bringing their letters together, how they use colors. You know, how they do their throw-ups, how they do their styles, from simple to technical, how they incorporate characters, how they incorporate background. You know, it's a challenge, man. Because see, back in the days, the black book is where everybody got down. You know, you would meet at the bench and you would exchange drawings and ideas and you would look at your black books, you know. Today, you know, they took that to the next step where people are competing against each other. So over here in Luxembourg, you know, they're really rocking it. Back to the books. It's a dope jam, man, for... You know, and it's for everybody. It's for whoever wants to come and battle. They're more than welcome, you know. Today's prize is going to be an original T-Kid sketch, man. You know, one of my black book pages and shit. They're going to get that, man. So, it's pretty dope, man.
So when I'm on tour, I represent the hardcore.